The first example is about a modification that increases the scope of the lease, and is accounted for as a separate lease. A lessee and a lessor signed a 5-year lease, where the lessee leased 10 vehicles for an annual lease payment of $1 million, payable at year-end. The lessee's incremental borrowing rate was 6% at the commencement date. At the beginning of year 3, both the lessee and the lessor agreed to amend the original lease by adding 5 more vehicles. The lease payment for the additional vehicles was $500,000, paid annually at year-end for the remaining lease term. A similar vehicle could be leased from the market at a higher payment of $105,000 on the modification date. The lessor charged the lessee a lower lease payment as a bonus for increased business between them. The lessee's incremental borrowing rate on the date of modification is 7%. Account for both the original lease and the lease modification. This is the calculation of the lease liability and the right of use asset for the original lease. Quite easy by now, nothing new. Here is the lease liability at the commencement date, which is the present value for the periodic payments of $1 million, discounted using the lessee's incremental borrowing rate of 6% over the lease term of 5 years. And this is the right of use asset. It includes only the initial measurement of the lease liability, as the example did not mention any components for the right of use asset. The journal entry to recognize the lease transaction at the commencement date is here. And the lease amortization schedule for the original lease. Now, let us account for the lease modification. At the beginning of the third year, both the lessee and the lessor agreed to amend the original lease by adding 5 more vehicles. The lease payment for these additional vehicles is $500,000 to be paid annually over the remaining 3 years. Let us check the two conditions to see whether we should account for these additional 5 vehicles as a separate lease, or by adjusting the original lease. The first condition. Does the modification increase the scope of the lease by adding a right to use one or more additional assets? The answer is yes. The modification increases the scope by adding the right to use 5 additional vehicles. So, the first condition is met. The second condition. Is the increase in the consideration for the lease commensurate with the standalone price of the additional vehicles? The modified contract stated that the consideration for the additional 5 vehicles amounts to $500,000, $100,000 per vehicle, payable annually. And although a similar vehicle can be leased in the market at $105,000, the lessor leased out the vehicles to the lessee at a discount, to reward the lessee for the increased business with the lessor. That discount is not a material discount, so we can say that the second condition is met as well, and that the increase in the consideration for the additional vehicles is commensurate with the standalone price for the additional vehicles. Since both conditions were met, then the modification should be accounted for as a separate lease. So, on the first day of the third year, which is the date of modification, the lessee should recognize a right of use asset and a lease liability for the lease of the additional vehicles. No adjustments are made to the original lease for this modification. This is the schedule for calculating the lease liability for the modification. The periodic payment for the new lease of the additional vehicles is $500,000. The lessee's incremental borrowing rate at the beginning of the third year, the date of modification, is 7%. The remaining lease term is 3 years. Insert the discount periods for the remaining years in the lease term. The periodic payments. The present value factors. And here is the lease liability for the separate lease. And the right of use asset. This is the journal entry to be booked in the lessee's books for the new separate lease. And finally, the amortization schedule for the new separate lease of the additional vehicles. In the next example, we will see a modification that also increases the scope of the lease, but is accounted for by adjusting the original lease. So please check the following lecture.